வணக்கம் ஐயா. வாட் ஆர் வி கோயிங் டு சி நெக்ஸ்ட் இன் அவர் சீரீஸ் ஆஃப் ஐம்லெஸ் மெடிடேஷன்ஸ்?
வணக்கம் மாரியப்பன். திஸ் இஸ் ஃபிஃப்த் இன் த சீரீஸ் ஆஃப் ஐம்லெஸ் மெடிடேஷன்ஸ். டு வி நோ ஒன் திங்? இன்டலெக்சுவலி வி ஆர் ட்ரெய்னிங் அவர் செல்ஸ் each moment, in each moment of our day. This is what is going on intellectually. The intellect is always in conflict. It fights within itself. It challenges. Lot of energy is drained, wasted. And as a result, our day-to-day life is also thwarted. Our performance is weakened because the intellect at the outset, whenever one issue pops up, immediately it is worried whether will I succeed or I will fail. Will I get that product or relationship or some kind of satisfaction or not? Will I complete a work, a function, a project or not? Will I reach or not? Am I right or wrong in doing this? Will it look good or bad in everyone's eyes? Everything is the image-making process of the I feeling that is actually run by the intellect. Intellect stations itself in our ego as our motives, drives, expectations, all the lot of that. This split has to be looked. So whenever one is in an issue, obvious, everyone is immersed in one issue or the other. That is how the image making process of the I feeling is setting everyone's intellect. So always one's intellect is dichotomized, split into dualities, pairs of opposites of feelings, objects, relationships, good and bad, like and dislike, succeed or fail, all the kinds of things. This is what our every moment of life is filled with, and it spoils our inner energy, the drive to lead our life, perform our life, because of this constant infighting going on, the strife going on in our intellect, in dualities of feelings, passions, emotions, and all the objects of the world, including relationships. So, in this 5 minutes of IMless meditation, what is it that one is going to do? Obviously, it is not one alone. The whole humanity is caught in this. So, what it has to do, whoever turns within, listening to this IMless meditation, what he has to do, he is already split in the intellect. He is in conflict in the intellect. He is in conflict. Be it an issue or no issue, he is already in conflict. Because there is always a gap in becoming and now this moment. So always the intellect runs oneself as that individual. So the split is unavoidable, but the fact of the split, this challenge, this conflict has to be constantly looked at. We are not going to do anything. We are just turning within and constantly looking at this is how it is being run by the centrally located control room in the intellect. The I feeling runs in the intellect like this constantly. this whole my world, my mind, that expresses itself as my world outside also, is run like this in conflict, in a fragmented way. So what this has to be realized, for this very realization, one has to turn within and look at wherever and whenever the issue is originated powerfully on an issue. When exactly one is stationed in an issue, one starts an issue to perform, at that moment of time, he has to be within himself, not pausing any evaluations, any judgments, because already the conflict is set. We are in conflict. We are dichotomized. We are split. We are challenging ourselves. So let it go. What are we going to do? We are going to be a non-dealer. We are not going to attend this. This is how this is. So intellect is essentially, fundamentally split in dualities. That fact has to be seen and seen again and again and again. It has to be seen within oneself with this inner eye. The same intellect gets the power to look within itself. See, wherever the issue arises, that is being run by the ego. The ego also knows, if the issue is stopped at the very outset or looked at the very outset, it is being seen through. This process of seeing through has to take place constantly. And this I amless meditation, especially looking at the dichotomy, the split nature of intellect, has to be done oftentimes in a day as 5 minutes I amless meditation. This one has to go on repeat doing it. One has to go on repeat doing it again and again, so that intellectually one becomes very powerful within oneself. It is not to prove to this world. It is not to prove to a relationship, to anyone outside of you. It is inner strength. Essentially, you, in the process of realizing oneself as well as performing in this world, in whatever the character role we are assigned to. This is what this I amless meditation is. We will meet in our next 5 minutes I amless meditation.
Thank you, Ayya.